The dust speck floated in deep, dark space, long before time created night or day. Other specks hung there, cold and grey, waiting in silence for something to change. Eons passed, and then came the waves. Terrible, ferocious, invisible, they crashed. Each speck's existence, now maybe its last. The power and force from a far-off blast squeezed, crushed, and folded the dust specks to gas. But nothing in life that exists can be gone. It changes from one thing to another, and on, and on, and on. The specks spun and they spun until the spin made them hot, and the dust specks had joined to become much larger rocks. Those larger rocks now spun around a golden ball of gas, made of bright burning energy, so hot and so vast. And how it blazed. From the heat and joining of specks once alone, arose incredible sights and sounds to behold. A rock formed from dust specks, placed third in line, was part of more planets, now totaling nine. At a distance so perfect, so lucky, so right, began the first moments of what we call life. The third rock, now warmed by the hot ball of gas, formed water so clear that life wriggled and splashed. It began with some creatures so tiny and small, to them a dust speck would be like a huge giant ball. Time passed and passed, and with luck on its side, the third rock grew species with ways to survive and thrive. Plant life and creatures spread all over the rock, changing their shapes and their colours and songs. Over cold winter nights and hot summer days, grew millions of species in dazzling arrays. Then, quite late to this rock, came an upstanding ape, with thinking and speaking that makes it so great. Over time that made changes, the ape became like you, a creature so smart, there's almost nothing you can't do. Flying higher than birds, diving deeper than whales, you have no need for fur, feathers, or shells. The brains in us humans got us first place on our rock, but just lately some problems are beginning to shock. Sometimes us humans can be greedy and wrong, thinking we can use for the rock as our own. Forgetting how lucky we are to be here, the luckiest of creatures, with a sun blazing near, we've started to ruin our blue speck of dust, the only speck able to give life to us. With desires for more and hunger so grand, we keep on consuming with endless demands. If all of the people who want only to take could go back in time to the invisible waves, they'd see it was luck that got us all here, a luck full of beauty that could bring them to tears. The chances of finding another blue ball are billions to one, or none, none at all. There is only one Earth that we can call home. If we love and protect it, life will thrive on. Let's avoid buying stuff we don't really need and eat foods grown without chemicals that are healthy and clean. Our oceans are getting empty and need a really long rest. Now is the time to eat fish a lot less. Ask those grown-ups who aren't wiser to use wind, sea and solar to fuel all cars, homes, phones, and computers. Right now is the time to make better decisions, helping our world remain a beautiful vision. If you looked at our home as if from far, far away, you'd see a blue speck floating out there in space. And if this blue speck was like a small grain of sand, would you cherish and protect it, held safe in your hands?